Hey guys, so I'm finally coming back to do my February monthly spread for you guys. I'm really sorry that it's coming to you like when February is almost done, but I got sick, as you know if you saw my previous video, and then other bad things happened. So I'm really sorry that this is so late. As you can see, I already did like a weekly spread in February before I even got to my monthly spread. That's how behind I've been this month. But I figured my things aren't exactly like themed month by month, so it wouldn't hurt to just upload this anyways for you guys. So I hope that you like it, even though it's very, very late. I hope that you still enjoy it. So yeah, I went to the fabric store. Well, I went to the fabric store, but I ended up buying paper, as one does. And I found this really cool sort of like astrological star chart print blue paper, and I was like, I have to use it for my spread this month because I really like it. And then sort of I based the rest of the theme off of this blue paper, and I was like, I'm gonna do gold on the blue paper, and then I'm gonna mix in some like florals. So it turned out a little bit differently. You'll see at the end. I mean, it turned out differently than some of the things that I normally do, but I kind of like it. I think it looks cool, and I hope you guys think it looks cool too. Also, I don't know if you guys can tell, but I burned my finger, so I have a band-aid on it. And am I the only one who thinks that there is a conspiracy with band-aid companies where they intentionally make them not sticky so that they fall off constantly? You have to keep putting on more band-aids because mine kept falling off, and that's why I have washi tape wrapped around it, which works really well and also makes it kind of cute. So, yeah. So, yeah, I'm just going in with my Uniball gel pen to write February in pretty script in this gold metallic color, which I think stands out really nice. I got the like lighting angle right on the video so you could actually see the letters, which is really cool. And then I paired it with this really pretty like sort of reclaimed rustic looking wood print because I thought it like accented the blue really well. So yeah. When I'm making my spreads, I sort of have started doing this thing where I decide to lay out like all the little all of the collage pieces first. So any pictures that I might include, any like little bits of paper or things, and then I go in and I sort of like figure out how everything's gonna be spaced, and I like move things around. So for this, I knew I didn't want to include any pictures. I typically don't with my monthly spreads. I usually just have prints. Sometimes I do like little drawings if I need to like fill up the space or something. But yeah. And then I'm going in and doing my calendar section, and this pen that I used is sort of a mustard color, and I was going for gold, but it doesn't quite look gold enough. I wish that Tombow would make metallic markers, because if they would just make a metallic gold marker, my life would be so much more complete. I have some gold watercolors that I've tried to use in my journal before, but it makes the pages wrinkle. Some people say that they can watercolor in their journals without it wrinkling, but I think that they're lying because I've never been able to make it work for me. So yeah, I'm just filling in the important dates. I put a little heart around Valentine's Day because it's Valentine's Day. I had to have like one heart in my monthly spread for February. Come on. If I didn't, I'd be like breaking the rules. And so now I'm using this like graph paper. I have a whole little book that's full of different like tones and colors and sizes of graph paper, and I really love it for the purpose of making these little charts that I fill out. So this one is for exercise because I'm trying to get back into exercise. Of course, my plans for the month were thwarted by the awful cold slash virus, whatever it was that I had, because like even just running around the house and playing with my dog was making me winded because it was like all in my lungs and awful. So I haven't gotten to work out nearly as much as I wanted. But, you know, it's there to track it anyways. And I'm putting in like the books that I'm gonna read this month. And you guys, this is the most depressing thing. They're the same books as last month. I've been in a reading slump and I don't know how to get out of it. I'm currently reading I'll Give You the Sun by Jandy Nelson, and I'm really, really liking it. It's really different than I thought it was going to be. And then when I'm done, because I'm almost done, I'm gonna read Throne of Glass. And I'm really excited because, I mean, it's so hyped, and I can't believe I haven't read it yet. But, anyways, I'm excited to read it. That's coming up. And then, here's a controversial thing. I put in this. print, which when I had originally envisioned the scheme being like navy, gold, floral print, and wood accents, I was like, this is cool. It's different. It's not something I typically do. However, once I added in that Tombow, the lines in the calendar that are more of a mustard color, sometimes I use it as gold and it comes off really gold, and sometimes it turns more mustard. And I feel like paired with the blue, it turned more mustard, and so that made the floral choice like a little bit strange and different, but I'm glad that I went with it anyways because I'm always trying to like experiment with like colors and patterns and see like what I can make go with what, what's an interesting combination. And I feel like it's an interesting combination. I feel like it would look better if I had a gold Tombow pen just saying Tombow, get on it. So yeah, now I'm making like some little headers for my goals section, and this month I decided that I would separate it into personal goals and business goals, because if you guys did not know, I have an Etsy shop and I've been working really extra hard on it recently. If you would like to check it out, you can go to etsy.com/shop/hemlockandrose. That is the name of my Etsy shop. I will put like a little link somewhere on this page right now. You can go check it out if you want, because I sell like wedding decor stuff and I sell like bullet journaly stuff, and there will be more stationery slash bullet journaly stuff up there fairly soon. But yeah, a lot of times in these videos you will see me using stickers, and those are stickers that I made. So if you ever see one and you're like, wow, I like that, you can go get one on my shop. I also have an Instagram for my shop. It's called Hemlock and Rose Design, and you can follow that. I will also link that in the description and somewhere in the video here. You can go follow that if you would like to see more things from my Etsy shop, and I do some bullet journal posts that are only on that page and some that are on my personal page, so it's kind of like it's wherever. They're on both pages, so if you want to see all my bullet journal things, I would follow both Instagrams. Yeah, I'm just going through and tacking everything down with my Tombow Glue Dots roller thingy, which I love very much. I don't know about you guys, but I'm really ready for it to be spring. Like, I know I said that the second Christmas is over, I'm ready for it to be spring, but I'm really ready now. I want to wear all my spring clothes. I'm tired of wearing pants. I like wearing shorts. So I think that's why I had to include this floral print. I was like, I need it to be spring. Especially because we're having, like, the coldest cold snap we've had all year right now. So, yeah. I also just changed out that originally said highlights there on that wood paper, and now it says gratitude. And the reason that I changed it out was because last month I did a sort of highlight section, and I just wrote like really exciting things that we did. And I, at the end of the month, I ended up taping in like a ticket from a show that we went to. And I changed it to gratitude because I was in my yoga class, and our instructor was talking about how just acknowledging what you're grateful for every day can help you to be happier overall. They've like scientifically proven it. And so I was like, you know what? I think I'm gonna try doing a gratitude log again, because I think that that could be really helpful for me. And yeah, we'll see if I like it. I may switch back to doing more of a highlights thing or more of a journaling thing. That's the great thing about bullet journals, is you can change it to be whatever you need for whichever month. So that's my bullet journal done. I hope that you guys liked it. Please subscribe to my channel to see more from me. I love you all. Bye-bye.